a police officer for about 20 years, and during the time I was a police officer, I was a field training officer. And the experience of giving some information to another person, and what ends up happening is that you see this moment of discovery on their faces when they realize that this actually works. So I think that was really neat, and I wanted to continue to expand on that. So I got a part-time job as a cop teaching at a community college. And once I started teaching that, it was an investigations class I was hooked. Eventually, I decided that I wanted to make the transition from full-time policing to full-time teaching. So I went back to school, and I got my doctorate in criminal deviance, and found that I could have the best of both worlds. I could still be in the policing area by training new cops, but I could also do this as a full-time job. You know, I really try to get them involved. So I think once they discover that the class is interactive, it's not just coming into the classroom watching me lecture, but rather, it's getting them involved in the discussions. It's getting them involved in the projects, such as the crime scene house, the lab, field trips, ankle bracelets, traffic accident investigations, guest speakers, all of that stuff. So it's this combination of learning. The book is just one aspect that lends itself to the other forms of learning. University of Tennessee in Martin, we have a unique agreement with them in that we are able to, as a college, send students each year down to the National Forensic Academy so that they can get a crash course in forensics taught by some of the leading experts in the nation. And whereas other schools out in that general area may send one student here or one student there, we're able to converse and stay up to date on changes that they've made as a program, because as a program we have this agreement with them. So that enables us to do things such as figure out how those credits are going to transfer in, how they look on their resume, and how that fits into the wider curriculum that we have here. So basically, you know, it's also something that one can put on their resume that very, very few students can put on their resume, is that they have graduated from the National Forensic Academy. When I spent the night in jail undercover for research, not that I was arrested, it was a challenge to remind yourself that you are actually a professor who's there doing research and not an inmate. The clothing, the smell, the surroundings very quickly make you believe that you've done something bad and that you're being punished for it. And so for me personally, I had to continue to remind myself every morning when I woke up and heard that buzzer and realized I was in an 8-foot by 8-foot cell, that I actually wasn't a bad person. So it lends a lot of insight into this idea of rehabilitation and what are we really doing as far as either harming or failing to really provide any real form of rehabilitation to these individuals. Don't get me wrong, they should be punished for what they've done. But how do we punish someone but at the same time make them understand that we're punishing the act, not the person? I don't think we've figured that out yet.